The next topic we are going to see is about the variation of g with latitude. Okay, so whenever we analyze the motion of the object in the rotating frames, we have to take into account the centrifugal force. So whenever we consider the object which is moving or when it is rotating, the force which you have to consider is what? The centrifugal force. Even though we treat Earth as an inertial frame, so adu vandu inertial frame ah nama vechitalum, okay, which is not moving, it is not exactly correct because the Earth spins about its own axis. Earth is also rotating, it is spinning abindradunala it is not in the inertial frame. So when an object is on the surface of the Earth, it experiences a centrifugal force. So ஒரு சர்ஃபேஸ் ஆஃப் தி எர்த்ல ஏதாவது ஒரு ஆப்ஜெக்ட் இருந்தது அப்படின்னா இட் இல் எக்ஸ்பீரியன்ஸ் வித் centrifugal force. Clear? That depends on the latitude of the object on the Earth. So on what latitude the object has been there on the Earth, based on that the centrifugal force depends on. If the Earth were not spinning, the force on the object would have been mg. இப்போ வந்து Earth வந்து spin ஆகல அப்படின்னா அந்த ஆப்ஜெக்ட்டுக்கு மேலே இருக்கிற ஃபோர்ஸ் என்னவா இருக்கும்? ஜஸ்ட் கிராவிடேஷனல் ஃபோர்ஸ். ஸோ விச் இஸ் ஈக்குவல் டு வாட்? mg. ஹென்ஸ் த ஆப்ஜெக்ட் எக்ஸ்பீரியன்ஸ் அண்ட் அடிஷ்னல் சென்ட்ரிஃபியூகல் ஃபோர்ஸ் டியூ டு ஸ்பின்னிங். ஸோ இட் ஹேஸ் அ கிராவிடேஷனல் ஃபோர்ஸ் அண்ட் ஆல்சோ அ சென்ட்ரிஃபியூகல் ஃபோர்ஸ். ஓகே, so what is the formula for centrifugal forces, which is mv square divided by r. So we have to take with this two equation, mv square by r and also this mg. Clear? So when we see the diagram here, so this is the center of the object. Okay, and here is where we are considering the point. Okay, so this point, it has a centrifugal force. That centrifugal force is what? mv square divided by r. Okay, so we can write either as mv square divided by r. The other equation which is here is because v is equal to what formula? V is equal to omega into r. Okay, so when you substitute omega r here, we get m omega square r square divided by capital R. Okay, so one value of R get cancelled, so we get m into omega square R. Okay, so this gives a formula for F. Clear? And this object also has a that is a gravitational force towards this. Okay, so how the both are, they are acting in the opposite direction. So here also we have to apply with a free body diagram. Okay, so that we can write with these two equations. Okay, so when you write the equation here, the centrifugal force, which is m omega square into r, now this r dash can also be written as r into cos lambda, where lambda denotes the latitude. Okay, so the component centrifugal acceleration experienced by the object due to the value of g, that is given by acceleration a is equal to omega square into r. Okay, so a is equal to omega square into r. So instead of r, we are writing here as r dash into cos lambda. Okay, and this r dash is again what? R dash is equal to nama ipo dhaan paathom, which is equal to what? R into cos lambda appdin paathuma. Okay, so substitute this r dash here, so we get omega square as it is, r into cos lambda, again one more lambda, so it is cos square, since r dash is equal to this formula. Clear? Then so g dash is equal to g minus a. Okay, so instead of a, we are writing as omega square r into cos square lambda. Okay, so if you consider this for two conditions at the equator, if you are seeing the value of lambda is equal to 0 and at the poles, we can say that lambda is equal to 90. First, if you substitute the value of lambda is equal to 0, cos 0 is 1, and so we get g dash is equal to g into omega square r. Okay, and so this value is maximum. Okay, so the acceleration due to gravity is minimum. Sorry, it is minimum. Okay, and the next is, if you are substituting this value to be 90, cos 90 is what? 0. So this full term becomes 0. So we get g dash is equal to g. So it is maximum. So we can say that at the equator, g dash is minimum, and at the poles, the value of g dash is maximum. Clear?